Here at Infertility TV, I get thousands of comments and questions from viewers like you. A common topic I see has to do with how boy or girl embryos are formed and whether anything can be done to influence that process. Frankly, there are a lot of myths. Today on Infertility TV, I am going to clear up all the confusion. A normal embryo is composed of one egg and one sperm. Whether an embryo becomes a male or a female depends on the chromosomes. Normal eggs contain one X chromosome, and normal sperm contain either one X chromosome or one Y chromosome. If a sperm with an X chromosome fertilizes an egg, the result will be a female embryo. If an egg is fertilized with a sperm containing a Y chromosome, the result will be a male embryo. Therefore, the sex of an embryo is always determined by the sperm. There is a myth that if the egg comes from one ovary, it will result in a boy, and if it comes from the other ovary, it will be a girl. This is not true. The eggs in each ovary are all the same. All eggs contain an X chromosome. It does not matter which side an egg comes from. This will not influence the gender of an embryo. If you are someone who had one of your ovaries removed, you still have the same chances for having a boy or a girl. Some couples who have had several children of one gender mistakenly believe that the male only has sperm with X chromosomes or Y chromosomes. This is not true. In all men, about half of the sperm will contain an X chromosome and about half will have a Y chromosome. If you happen to have multiple children of the same sex, it is due to nothing more than random chance. Each time an embryo is made, there is a 50% chance for it to be a male and a 50% chance that it will be a female. So let's take an example. If 100 couples make an embryo, half will be males and half will be females. Let's say that the group that had males makes a second embryo. On average, about half of those will be males and half will be females. For the third embryo, it's the same. So, about 12 to 13% of couples who have three pregnancies in a row will have the same gender, just based on random chance. There is nothing medically different or wrong with these couples. Essentially, they have flipped a coin three times and got heads all three times. Can you do anything on your own which will influence the chance of having an X-bearing sperm or a Y-bearing sperm to fertilize an egg? Here are some of the techniques that have been asked about. Will having intercourse closer or further from the time of ovulation influence the gender of an embryo? No. A study of over 200 couples showed no impact. Will changing your sexual position so that the sperm is released closer or further from the cervix influence the gender of an embryo? No. Multiple studies have produced conflicting results for this myth. Are there supplements that a male can take which will increase the chance for producing a boy or a girl in his partner? No. Does having low testosterone levels or high levels change the chances for having a boy or a girl? No. Does the length of time since the last delivery influence the chances for having a boy or a girl? No. If there is nothing that you or your partner can do to change the chances for a boy or a girl, is there anything that a fertility doctor can do? One common fertility treatment, IUI, or intrauterine insemination, is sometimes recommended to couples for this purpose. But large studies have shown that this does not change the chance for a baby of any particular sex. IVF is another common fertility treatment. IVF by itself also does not change the chances for a boy or a girl. However, after an embryo is created, it can be tested to determine whether the embryo is a male or a female embryo. This is called PGT, or pre-implantation genetic testing. If you are lucky enough to have an embryo which is the gender you are looking for, you can choose to place that embryo into your uterus. This is the only method currently that is scientifically proven to help you get the gender you are looking for. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, ivf1.com, where you can become a patient.